Rokia Begum's family has farmed this land on the banks of River Bangshi for generations. Now, her home is badly polluted.
We used to drink water from this river and cook food with it. Now, we can't even wash our hands here. We get rashes in our feet if we stand in these paddy fields. We can't eat fish from these waters. Don't you see there are no more fishermen around?
The Department of Environment has already classified three rivers around the capital as biologically dead because of pollution. The environmental impact of clothing production in Bangladesh shows how the true cost of cheap textile is being felt by the very poorest living downstream from polluting factories. While the production goes up day by day, the desire to cut pollution does not. Some factories conceal drains which dispose of untreated waste.
All these factories built large drains and then installed large pipes inside the drains. When wastewater comes out from these drains, the stench is so awful you can't stand here.
The poor bear the brunt of pollution.
We're facing a lot of health problems. These waters are so dirty, it's nauseating. We can't cultivate anything in this land.
Treating factory wastewater is an expensive process.
Already we have invested a lot to make our plant environmental friendly and sustainable, but at the end the buyer are not willing to pay to keep it sustainable.
A World Bank study said four major rivers near Dhaka receives nearly 1.5 million cubic meters of wastewater every day from 7,000 industrial units in surrounding areas. Some textile factory owners have been fined, while others say they're sticking to government rules.
At the moment, you know, the Bangladesh government is very conscious regarding the environment. I think all the factories complied their compliance as per rules of our government, as per international rules and the international compliance.
High Court judges made history earlier this year by declaring Bangladeshi rivers as living bins. As demand for relatively cheap Bangladeshi clothes remains high worldwide, it is the waterways and rivers here that are paying the price. Tanvir Chowdhury, Al Jazeera, Savar, Bangladesh.